So what I'm showing you here is sort of a software engineering roadmap to synthesizing a complex system. So what we're going to do is, first we're going to go from specification to implementation. And this figure shows the workflow in building a complex system. In particular, what they focused on is a TCP/IP network protocol stack using this methodology of the design cycle that I presented. So we start with what is called an abstract behavioral spec. Now, this is where we use this I/O automata. And this abstract behavioral spec is where we describe the functionality of the subsystem in terms of requirements. And we are presenting the high-level logical specification of the components. And the specification is really talking about the properties that we want the subsystem to adhere to, not how it is going to be accomplished or how it is going to be executed, but the properties that it has to adhere to. For example, in the protocol, if we desire that the packet should be delivered in order, that's a property that we want for that subsystem. Those are the behavioral properties that you can express using the I/O automata. And other behavioral specification properties that you can have are things like, well, on every packet, there should be an acknowledgement. That's another property that you want the protocol to have. You can express that using the I/O automata. So the abstract behavioral spec is simple and lends itself to deriving properties about the behavior of the system, not the execution, but the behavior of the system, such as FIFOness and so on. It is not executable code, even though I told you that the syntax of I/O automata is similar to C. It's not executable code, but the interesting thing is that once you have expressed the abstract behavioral properties, you can actually verify whether the behavioral specification meets the properties that you want in the subsystem. So proving that the behavioral spec meets the properties is facilitated by the I/O automata theoretical framework. That's the nice thing about this behavioral spec. Once we know that the behavioral spec is meeting the properties that we set out for the subsystem, then we are ready to roll our sleeves and go down the path of implementing the behavioral properties. Next step in that process is getting to a concrete behavioral spec. We get to this concrete behavioral spec from the abstract behavioral spec through a whole set of refinements to this abstract behavioral spec. For instance, the refinement could be that if I have a queue data structure, I want first come, first serve property. How do I make sure that the abstract behavioral spec adheres to that additional execution condition that I want of first come, first serve? Those are the kinds of things that I can do in refining the abstract behavioral spec to get a concrete behavioral spec. This is still not code, but it is closer to code than abstract behavioral spec. It's closer to implementation. And from the concrete behavioral spec, we get to the actual implementation using OCaml as the programming language. And between the implementation and the concrete behavioral spec, there is not a whole lot of difference. It is really the scheduling of the operations that we want in the concrete behavioral spec that is being detailed when we go from this step to this step in producing OCaml code, which is finally an executable code for the original abstract behavioral spec that we started with. I already mentioned some of the reasons why they chose OCaml as the implementation vehicle: functional programming language, formal semantics, and it also leads to compact code, high-level operations on data structures, and also it has features like automatic garbage collection, automatic memory allocation, and marshaling and unmarshaling of arguments. This is very important because I mentioned that we are going towards building a complex system from a specification using a component-based design approach, which means that we're going to take these components and mesh them together, just like you take Lego blocks to build a toy. Similar to that, we are taking components and meshing them together to get the complex implementation. And when we do that, we are necessarily going across different components. And when we go across different components, you have to adhere to the interface specifications of those components, which means you have to marshal the arguments and unmarshal the arguments when you go between these components. And OCaml has facilities for doing these kinds of marshaling and unmarshaling built into the language framework, which makes it an ideal vehicle for component-based design. And also the programmability of OCaml is similar to C, and the definition of the primitives in OCaml makes it a good vehicle for developing verifiable code.